It all boils down to this. I'm Essie Cupp. Welcome to Unfiltered. It's been 6 weeks of testimony and hearings in which the tragic and unprecedented story of the January 6th insurrection at the U.S. Capitol has been told from dozens of different angles. We've heard from Capitol Police officers whose lives were endangered that day. We've heard from White House staffers, one of whom was on the mall with the president when armed Trump supporters marched to the Capitol, determined to overturn the election. We've heard from election workers whose lives have been upended as former President Trump and his cronies baselessly accuse them of tampering. We've even heard from members of Trump's family and inner circle. There was a lot we already knew because we watched it happen with our own eyes, but there was a lot we didn't know. Incredible, unbelievable, alarming stories of a president unhinged, allegedly throwing a plate at the wall, trying to cajole a Secret Service agent into driving him to the Capitol, threatening state officials and attempting to seize voting machines. Now, the Department of Justice will determine what of these stories amounts to criminal conduct, if anything. But for the rest of us, what did all of this amount to? What can we take away? Well, there are really only two important questions. What did Trump know and when did he know it? First, did he know the election wasn't stolen?
I told him that the stuff that his people were shoveling out to the public was bullshit. I mean, that the claims of fraud were bullshit.
Try to put it in very clear terms to the president. The major allegations are not supported by the evidence developed. We've looked at Georgia, Pennsylvania, Michigan, Nevada. We're doing our job. Much of the info you're getting is false.
Yet, he continued to push the falsehood that the election was rigged. And Trump pushed the Justice Department to do everything it could to act as if it were rigged.
You also noted that Mr. Rosen said to Mr. Trump, quote, DOJ can't and won't snap its fingers and change the outcome of the election. How did the president respond to that, sir?
He responded very quickly and said, essentially, that's not what I'm asking you to do. What I'm just asking you to do is just say it was corrupt and leave the rest to me and the Republican congressman.
He also knew that some of his supporters on January 6th were armed before they marched to the Capitol, where they threatened the lives of the vice president and lawmakers. He did nothing to stop them.
And his response was to say they can march to the Capitol from the ellipse.
Something to the effect of, take the effing mags away, they're not here to hurt me, let them in, let my people in, they can march to the Capitol after the rally's over.
And as we learned in the final hearing, Trump specifically didn't want any sort of mention of peace in a tweet his aides were crafting, nor did he want to admit in a speech he finally gave that the election was over.
But this election is now over. Congress has certified the results. I don't want to say the election's over. I just want to say Congress has certified the results without saying the election's over, okay?
So to sum up, Trump knew the election was fair, and still he tried everything he could to effectively rig it himself. He knew his supporters wanted to overturn the election, and he knew some of them were armed. He knew all of this before his supporters breached the Capitol. And despite knowing all of this, he chose not to stop them and not to say the election was over. The result? A country on the brink of a coup. Violence, vandalism, and fatalities. Lives ruined. Hundreds of people charged with crimes. An electorate divided and untrusting of a system that unequivocally worked. A new breed of political candidate emboldened to follow in Trump's footsteps, vowing to ignore election results they don't like. So knowing that, ask yourself this very simple question. Should a man capable of all of that destruction ever be allowed back into the White House? That's it for me. See you next week.